Good morning. 9:32 right now. I'll give you an update. We just left city court. Now, this was a case that's, I think it's a month and a half, 2 months old. This is prior to us finding that sex camp, which was a sex camp. And it involves a street thug dope dealer that was attempting to assault a homeless veteran. When I got in between the two, he continued to move forward to attack both me and him. So I simply just pepper sprayed him, stepped back, called 911, cooperated with the police and everything. So I just went through. They're setting a trial date for that on July 17th or June 17th. It's supposed to be a 1.5 hour trial, but I got notified that there is information within police reports that is proving our case, that actually helps our case. Now, this isn't unknown for when police don't know and something happens and you have two versions of the story. Now, we had a retired cop, a 30-year retired cop, that actually witnessed the whole thing, and then the homeless veteran who was being assaulted, but we got him out of the area. The street thug had a guy that gave him a skateboard to come back and attack us with the skateboard after he got maced, which he ended up running down the street. And remember, we were the ones who initiated the contact with law enforcement, fully cooperated. The fact that this is going to trial, it's kind of surprising, but it doesn't really matter to me. There's no issues right now. There is a local reporter there, Tim Steller, just asking cases. I answered a few questions. Now, our mission goes. It's a 3-year mission. We don't care what anyone says. We did see the Oath Keepers webinar, and we heard Ron Thompson and Bob Houston and their assessment. We respectfully disagree. One thing they don't mention is that the police never came to secure the scene, and we begged for them to come secure the scene. Then we begged Department of Homeland Security and the FBI to come secure the scene. So the evidence was never tainted until the law enforcement and local government and federal government refused to come out, and they just refused to come out and secure the scene. They didn't even want to look at the other camp with the condoms and everything that people said that weren't there. Well, no, they were there. We got them. The evidence would have never been brought out had VOP not done everything possible to let you guys know that this really was happening and something stinks. And it does stink. They bulldozed an entire site. So for anyone who would like to criticize VOP's leadership, you know, that's fine. We're on the ground. They're running around in air-conditioned offices and having little meetings and webinars. And look, anyone who's saying send us money to go down and investigate, look, you can come down and investigate for free. We'll let you come in, come down for 7 days. Now, I just authorized Vice, and I'm going to meet with my staff. We're going to allow Vice, we're authorizing them. We might amend the 7 days down to 4 days so they can get out with all the vets at all our camps and show people exactly what we're doing that's not going to put us in any security risk to give up all of our information. So we are letting people come down. It's not like we're denying people to come down and see the truth. But understand, that individual who built that camp would have never, ever been found had we not done what we did. Had we not secured the evidence, had we not blown it up so every local would see it, and that's how he found out about it, and then he panicked. And he's changed his story 3 times. Now, in their own webinar, Ron Thompson even says they're changing their story, and the son says it was for an illegal camp and they were helping illegals, and then dad cuts them off. If you listen to everything they say, well, then everything they say means what we found was true, but they're saying that we destroyed all the evidence that could be prove it. No, it's not. The evidence is still in our possession. Now, what we did was we had our staff go through the evidence securing training program. This way, the next time the government decides to stand down, we can properly process everything, and then maybe they'll take the evidence and go and investigate. Now, there was no 3 investigations by TPD. We have plenty of witnesses on the ground. They refused to come out. They're supposed to send a detective out in the morning. I watched over that place all night. All night. No detective came all day. And I spotted the spotter that was watching us. This is the same guy we tracked all the way out to where we are right now, where Alpha Camp is. Okay, this is the same guy we lost at a compound that's being used by the cartels all the way at the very end of Manville Road, not probably 2 miles down from where the child's skull was found. And we still tell you that was a small child's skull. All teeth have been removed, lower jawbone missing, decapitated. So we have taken steps to learn how to properly secure evidence. But as far as armchair quarterbacks and people who say all this stuff, look, we don't care. We're out here every day. We've got 4 more teams that are just going out. I came here and met 2 other guys that just came down from other states. So we have people that are coming out continuously, and they're going out and they're telling their friends and families what's happening, the evidence we're showing them. So it doesn't really, criticism and Monday morning quarterbacking for what we did doesn't make any sense, because no one would know the truth if we didn't do what we did. If we played by the system's rules and we played by the government's rules, no one would have found out who built that camp. We wouldn't have found out where the scouts' trails were. We wouldn't have found out the secret corridor had we not gone in. And remember, the Oath Keepers got to see maybe 40% of the end. We're not. There was evidence we had to sneak out in trash bags, guys. Trash bags. Mixed in trash, you know. And then stuff that's still buried out there. And we just got report from our people watching, Mr. Andres trespassed on CMIX property yesterday. He went under the I-19 bridge, the same bridge that the illegals were using, the cartels access it. They get dropped on the north side. There's two tunnel washes underneath two billboards. They used to shoot the lights out to mark the billboards, but now Clear Channel automatically turns the lights out at 11 o'clock. So they move in under the tunnel. Well, Mr. Andres, he went there yesterday. He trespassed on CMIX property, didn't ride his horse down through the backside. He came down and accessed the property from under things. So he knows what we're doing. So obviously, you know, well, we still got eyes on you. We have not one let you get away with what you did out there and the people that helped you. But we also have a huge problem where you're able to access these children because we've got wide open borders and they're able to cross. So guess what? We're going to stay out there and prevent sick perverts like you from being able to tie little children on trees. And people call that sensational, and you know, it doesn't make any sense. Your own government reports say it happened. But it's sensationalism when we discover it and produce evidence. And the government stood down. Remember that, guys. We asked for help. So you can't say VOP screwed up the evidence when we asked for help and no government official or local law enforcement agency would come secure the scene. And we did send TP down there the very first night and walk through with them, and they took pictures. And then they walked away. You could tell just by the way the supervisor was acting. It's easier just to say it looks like a homeless camp than it was to actually do an investigation and figure out why the hell is this camp and others on CMEX property. Who is this Mexican company, mining company, that leased that those towers and that lot for 30 years? No one wants that. We haven't heard anything about that. So keep pushing, keep digging on that. But the truth in the end will vindicate us. I'm very proud of our staff. I'm very proud of our volunteers, because even with all the criticism that comes from these quote-unquote experts and these people that'll raise money to come do a job, they're still down here doing it for free. God bless them. And if you want to come down and see for yourself and actually make a difference on the border instead of criticizing those of us who are actually on the ground, come down. Because we've seen a lot of hearts and a lot of naysayers change when they get down here and they find these children's clothing and these little shoes and these human trafficking corridors. And they get to see what a lot of people don't get to see. We don't get to go on live video for every searches. We don't. And we won't. But you're allowed to come down and be there. And you're allowed to be in the recordings when the GoPro cams are recording all this evidence. And we've got... We've got so much. Like I said, we could use 1,000 more bodies. This is a huge desert. But we think God's sustaining everything we need. He's sending us the people to need to do our job. We're impatient. We want to get the shield built around our city as fast as possible, so then we can go and do more disruption, both inside the city with these pedophilia rings and outside, pushing them all the way back down to our southern border so they can't cross up here and traffic in these women and children. Now remember, we're going out, any woman or child that's being trafficked, that's being abused, that's being held, we're providing sanctuary for. Any bad guys, let Border Patrol take care of them. Let Border Patrol get all the drug mules, it's not a problem. We're specifically out looking for women and children to help, that's it. And if we wanted to sit there and bust drug mules and set up cameras around where the drug routes were and everything like that, we could do that all day. We don't have to. We've got neighbors that are providing properties for us to set up OPs. We've got eyes down in washes that once the cartel used to control. We've got drones that'll fly the sky. You know, they have drones, we have drones. The only thing we don't have is the ground sensors that they have. Our guys definitely don't have the artillery that the cartels have, because they get most of their supplies from the federal government itself. Look at Fast and Furious. And to mention any of this stuff, they'll try to say, well, you're a conspiracy theorist. Look, we have QAnon. We have even them coming back. There's a lot of theories related to pedophilia in our state. We're going to go and fact check every single one. We don't care if we're investigating the Clinton Foundation, the Trump administration, a liberal, a conservative. We don't care who it is. We're going to go and find actual facts because we're going to be on the ground every day while the experts are in their offices making decisions or criticizing what's going on. We appreciate anyone that wants to come down and look at it, and we don't even care if you agree or disagree or if you want to leave certain facts out to justify and saying we should have done things that way. We tried it your way, and the government didn't come. So we did it our way, and we found out who built the bunker. We found a secret human corridor that we've been pounding, and we've done more effect to the cartel within the past 14 days, 2 weeks, than anyone else has ever done. That's a fact. We're destroying the old. It's almost like the Minutemen without all the. We're going to go down and arrest every wetback coming across the street. I mean, that's the language you had from the. We have people that are coming out and saying we're going to take care of any woman or child we find. That's it. That's the number one mission. That's it. We're going to take care of any woman or child we find being trafficked across this corridor. We don't care which way they're going, what nationality they are, what legal status they are. But anyone else, we're not offering that. We're not offering that. We're telling them, hey, man, go do it the legal way. Hey, don't bring the dope up into our area. And we know what we're doing is working because it's been a little bit harder to get drugs in South Tucson. So Bravo Base is going to benefit from us being out there on the ground because now you ain't going to have the meth dealers and the crack dealers and the heroin dealers coming after these guys to get their incomes. They're having a hard enough time going to get their drugs. And, you know, you've had some of these guys, they've had 3-4 days they've had to wait for supplies to hit them. And we got this intel ourselves from the very homeless community. And these are individuals who stop doing drugs. They go into sobriety. These are individuals who give us the intel on all the drug dealers who were keeping them out there, who were poisoned. Our sources come from the people who've been affected, just like with these children being trafficked. We have children, adults now, who are prior traffic victims that we take our advice and leadership from. We have human trafficking victims who know what that camp was, who saw that camp. We take our advice from them. We don't take our advice from anyone who's been in the system, especially if they've been in law enforcement for 40 or 50 years, because that's part of the problem. The corruption is part of the problem. And you had this this scare thing where people just don't want to throw people under the bus, okay? Well, I'll throw you under the bus if you come out here to cause problems. I don't care. We have a mission. It's a 3-year plan. We're not going nowhere. We're getting ready to go out there and beat feet in the desert again. Every single day, we are going to pound that sand. Every day, we are not going to stop. We thank you guys for continuing to support us. We love you guys. We really do. We're so appreciative. And for my staff, letting me spend last night with my wife and daughter, it was good. I'm refreshed. I'm ready to go. We don't have to worry about anything other than keep doing it right. The only way this stops is if we mess up. That's it. So we're just not going to mess up. That's it. And anyone wants to come down and cause problems, I'll stick the camera right in front of your face and show the world who you are. If you're not down here to help us look for children, then you're going to be thrown under the bus. Simple as that. And if you want to criticize our operation, go make your own operation. Because every operation the system makes does nothing but perpetuate pedophilia and the sex trafficking of children. That's it. And we do everything the opposite. We threw the rule book out, and guess what? That rule book's being rewritten by people who want to get the job done, who aren't going to listen to the far left, the far right, the experts in the system, and the ones that want to completely have anarchy. No. In the middle somewhere. We're creating a new rule book, and we're more effective than anyone else. If you want to come down here and challenge it, I challenge you to bring your group down. You're more than welcome. We got 22 acres. You can set up 2-acre plot on our FOB, and you can run your own search and rescue as long as you do it legal and safe by certain rules that we have set place. Other than that, you make your own rule book. You go out there. You disrupt the hell out of these cartel trafficking corridors, because that's what we're going to keep doing. The more people coming down and support us, the more you're going to see the trickle-down effect of people finally getting help. You're just going to see it, and solutions coming. And God bless all of our neighbors and ranchers out there that have our back, that are standing up against the corrupt ranchers. And those of you that are in bed with the cartel, guess what? Your live videos and your addresses where cartel coyote traps are moving in, and videos of them moving in and out of your property, all that stuff's going to start going out public so the world can see we're not just saying you're helping the cartels. We're showing video proof that you're allowing them to come on. So we ask all of our neighbors with private property to post your private property. Every single one, post it. If you need help, we'll do it for free. If you want us to help repair the fences where they cut through your property and you don't want them in there no more, you contact us. We'll go do everything we said, and then we'll keep an eye on your property. If you want a combat vet to come down and post up on your property and watch it, you let us know. We'll send you down someone that's highly trained and who will run his own mission separate. VOP leadership doesn't do nothing but stay on the ground. Everyone else who comes out, they're their own leadership. And they're doing their own searches. And we appreciate all of them acting independently, because once again, this isn't about veterans on patrol. It's about children who are crying in our desert. It's about a system that continues to perpetuate the sick things happening to these kids, man. So we're going to keep on keeping on. We love you guys. Have a good day.